To our legal line, our legal analyst, Jeff Hosford from Hosford Law Firm is joining us. And Jeff, not talking about that case specifically, but in the case of registered sex offenders, talk to us about the requirements for registered sex offenders and why they have to register.
Well, obviously, it's a community safety requirement. There's a belief and there's some proof that people that do these crimes recommit them, as shown possibly in this case. So what they've done is they've required them to go ahead and register where they live so those people can be kept up with to ensure the safety of the citizens of that community. In the state of Mississippi, you can do a simple Google search. Just go Mississippi Sex Offenders Registry List, and it'll pop up a list that is a .gov list. You go on that website, and you can search anywhere in your area and see where everyone that is registered is located.
Now, as I understand it, anyone convicted of a sex crime who then registers as a sex offender, each time they move, whether it's from one community to another, one town to another, and obviously one state to another, they have to re-register their address. Is that correct?
If they change addresses at all, they're required within a certain period of time to register. If they fail to register, it's a felony crime, and they can be charged with failure to register. So it's an extra requirement that they have to do due to the charge against them. And in fact, I believe they have to update it periodically, even if they don't move, just to verify that they're still at the same address.
All right, Jeff Hosford, we always appreciate your perspective. If you have a question for Jeff, you can send it to us at legalline@wcbi.com. We'll see you next week.
Thank you for having me.